Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Morrowind. As per usual, we are jumping on in here, and before I forget to mention it, this Let's Play is brought to you by my amazing my amazing supporters over on Patreon, who are all just, so awesome. Anyways, where we last left off, we kind of poked around in town a little bit, and we are kind of taking our first steps out into the wide world now. And I'm actually thinking that in future episodes, I'm probably going to go ahead and skip the main menu and just start us off in-game, probably at the escape screen, just to kind of save what looks to be in about, I don't know, maybe 30 seconds worth of recording there. You guys don't need to see the main menu every time. Damn! Look at that! This is actually one of the mods I'm running that came with the overhaul. It has, like, sun shafts and stuff. It's crazy, some of the shit that people have retrofitted into this engine that at this point is 16 years old. Well, 14 years old, I should say. Man, this game is nice looking. I'm going to encounter my first cliff racer. I know it's coming up. I also know that if you look up... Oh, there he goes. Oh. How's that fallen damage working out for you, Tarheel? The Journal of Tarheel. I believe I may have found the correct formula for the spell I am developing. With it, I will be able to travel great distances without the need to pay for the service. If all goes well, I will test out the new spell tomorrow. I believe I have worked out all of the possible complications. It will allow me to leap great distances covering many hundreds of miles. Never before has one been able to travel in this manner, vaulting from the ground, sailing through the sky, all without the terrible disorientation of a spell of flying. The time is almost upon me. My research is finished and all of my calculations are checked and rechecked. They laughed at me when I suggested this. We'll see who laughs after I leap to the top of their towers and scream out my success. Yeah, you're, what is this, Incarian Flight? Yeah. 1,000 points into acrobatics. You guys have seen what 7 does. This is 1,000. It kills you because you jump, but by the time you land, it's worn off. And then you land and you die. But the big thing about this is actually this longsword that casts spark on hit. Now, if I recall correctly, magic items in this, their charge, I think it recharges with time. I may be wrong. I also seem to recall being able to wear robes over armor, which is one of my favorite things ever. And we're gonna leave his corpse there as a warning to others. Alright, so let's poke around a little bit. We've got a whole... Oh, it's a scrib. Are you hostile? Am I gonna make you regret this? Nah, you don't look hostile. I immediately regret this. I've drawn an arrow and I can't... Damn it. Here. Okay. I just accidentally popped out a third person. Hey there, little buddy, how you doing? These guys will paralyze you if you're not careful. I'm not too worried about it, though. At this point, no. Now, you guys will note that there's gonna be, this is a Bethesda game, so there's gonna be, like, the kind of stuttering as it loads cells and stuff. I do have it loading cells into the distance so you can get, like, the distance views like that, for example. Normally, the view distance in this game is not great, and even now, as you can tell, it is somewhat limited. But that's okay. Now this thing, I was gonna say, yeah, this is gonna be hostile. I'm tempted, actually, to just, yeah, might as well train up my marksmanship on it. It's of no threat. Little Quama Forager, go ahead and take my arrow back. And you do know that they don't stack with the ones that I have equipped, which is something that I'm sure that I'm going to be whinging about for the extent of this Let's Play, but, you know, whatever. What am I gonna do about it except bitch? Now, you'll also know that my casting chances have gone down. That is because I am wearing heavy armor. I believe the more armor I am wearing, the lower my casting chances get. So if I remove all of this stuff, for example, and do this, you'll know that I think my Spark's casting chances went up to 63, maybe not. I don't know. Oh, it's probably because I'm out of fatigue. I could have sworn that your casting chances in this were actually based on the armor you're wearing. Almost certain that they were. I don't know. Maybe I'm just going insane. It could very well be based on the fact that I'm just wholly and utterly fatigued right now. Oh, got him. Getting stuck in the terrain. Jesus. We have a mine we could explore. Mines are typically full of those Quama, and I, generally speaking, don't want to deal with them. So, okay, yeah, it does look like our chances are based on our, fatigue, which that's honestly not how I remember it being, but whatever. Zane Sipuliu, Zane something or other. So what I want to do is see Trying to remember how map notes and stuff worked. Yeah, you can sit there and do Scrib things, Scrib. I don't really care too much about you. Kind of poke around, get a feel for how the slopes in this one work. This is a, you know, an Elder Scrolls game. You're gonna have to master mountain climbing eventually, one way or another. Oh man, that just sucks away my fatigue. And the thing that I actually remember most about this game is, with regards to world navigation, I don't think there are really any invisible walls. And the reasoning behind that is it actually takes place on an island, so the invisible wall is kind of, you know, a natural wall in that you're surrounded by ocean. But I always thought it was really cool because you can pretty much go just about anywhere and it's really quite useful for navigation. I keep hitting M to bring up my map. I just gotta remember that it's tab. Alright, so I'm gonna keep going in this direction. We are kind of slowly foraging our way here to Balmora. That is my ultimate goal. Okay, that is a Quama. I think a Quama worker, perhaps? I don't know. I just know that these things are actually kind of dangerous in the early game. Still. Hey, we popped it with an arrow. I don't think it's gonna be too much of a threat to us, though, because you very, very much can use terrain to your advantage in this game. Man, we're actually doing quite well with our bow. I'm surprised. What is this, a worker? Yeah. See, I remember. We got workers and foragers and stuff. I think their eggs heal you, and I have no idea what Cuddle does. We might as well take it. Because, hey, why not? I really... Honestly, what I should be doing is probably casting spells on these things to kind of... Oh, yeah, I see that. That's some texture issues right there with the grass. But only when you're looking up at it. Apparently there's a snake around here somewhere, too. Thank you, cork bulb. You've gathered one cork bulb root. Damn right. Just gonna continue moseying along here. Keeping an eye on the road. I know there are bandits and stuff out and about, so we do kind of have to be careful. I'm not super, super worried. At least not yet. The world in this is not like in Skyrim and Oblivion, say, where encounters are leveled to you. There's some of that, but generally speaking, monsters and stuff do not scale. All right, these are two guys. That's a mine we can go into in Balmora, if I recall correctly, is right on the other side of this. This little range here. And if we follow this around, there's gonna be a crypt on our left. That is one ugly outfit. Fuck you, buddy. Don't make me come over there and magic your ass. Yes, there's the crypt, and there's typically, at this point in time, probably gonna be a scrib meandering about out here guarding it. But it does not appear so. All right, I'll take it. Go ahead and sleep. We will rest for an hour just to kind of get our stamina and stuff back. And we're gonna go inside. I'm also thinking, honestly, that we need to get a light spell. Like I said, Balmora is right on the other side of this ridge here. I do like exploring this cavern early. However, we may have to go ahead and use our silver sword because sometimes there are ghosts that spawn in here. So we're gonna equip our torch. This, as you can see, casts much more light than our poor torches. And I'm going to save because ghosts can be nasty at this point in the game. If we're lucky, it'll just be a skeleton. I also seem to recall, I think maybe this door being trapped. Yes, as you can see, it says trapped. There's a mod to actually remove that, but we will try and disarm the trap. I don't recall whether disarming traps is a separate skill or not. Does not look like it. Is it under security? Open locked doors, lockpicks, or disarm traps with probes. Okay. Come on, skeleton. That sounds, I think, a ghost. I think that's a ghost. That is a ghost. Ancestor spirit. Lightning death. Man, these new spell effects are really nice. This actually was a mod I was looking at installing, but I'm like, maybe not. I want to kind of keep things, you know, closer to the base game. But then I just decided, ooh, exclusive invisibility, nice. Restore fatigue, nice. Theris chest key, an iron dagger, scroll of lesser domination. This could be useful. I think that'll make things friendly towards me. Good for, you know, spamming on shopkeepers. Book of Dawn and Dusk. is a collection of sayings and aphorisms attributed variously to the tribunal and their saints and servants. Okay, then. We will take it. I'm not going to be reading books. I'm sorry if you want that, but just, no. Shrine of Saint Veleth. Donation of 35 and receive a blessing? Sure. Ooh. How about Veloth's indwelling? Let's see here. Is there a way to check what I have on me? Fortify Magicka. Nice. I'll take that. I will take the hell out of that. Alright. Oh, that's a skeleton. Hey there, buddy! Fucking. Ah! You're not a smart skeleton, are you? I mean, oh, there he goes. Woof! Popped me one. So he's got an iron shield, an iron saber, and some bone meal. Clothes. An urn with, I was gonna say, these typically just have bone meal in them. But you never know. And they are pretty good about hiding stuff in dungeons. So I do kind of want to poke around just a little bit. What the hell? Oh, just, that's smoke from my torch. I actually didn't realize it was emitting smoke and I freaked out a little bit. All right, an emerald, that's 150 gold. Some comm berries, a chest, and another chest we have a key to. So we'll go ahead and pop that. And we got a chitin spear, an iron saber. We're nearing encumbrance. Where's my probe? We'll go ahead and try to, I recall this trap being quite dangerous, actually. Like, it would probably kill me at this point in the game. Come on. There we go. Level that security. And it's empty! Man, if that just ain't a kick in the jewels. Screw you, skeleton. Screw you, ghost. I killed you all. With my lightning! I love it. Alright. I'm gonna sheath our sword here. Don't need to have that out. Go on, get into Balmora, which I happen to know that normally, I don't know if our acrobatics is gonna be high enough, but if your acrobatics isn't garbage, you can actually kind of navigate up this cliff here. Oh, am I gonna be able to squeeze? Oh, there we go. And this will take us right over into town. There's a silt strider, and there's the town. It's like I've run this way a couple times before. Normally, Balmora is kind of my home base. I think it's probably pretty much, I don't say everyone's home base, but I know a lot of people make it their home base. Alright, so we have made it. Man, look at this, we're so badass looking. I'm gonna pull my sword out, I'll shank this Argonian. Hey there, Hool Hull. Fish game, come at me. And I happen to know this is actually a general store right here. Pawn broker, whatever, close enough. Okay, I suppose I can kind of put my torch away. Can I just, no, I can't just, well, can I just, there we go. All right, I don't need to be carrying that thing, getting annoying. Greetings, citizen, I am Drolasa Nithirian. Welcome to Balmora. We are House Lalu Town and loyal citizens of the Empire. What can I do for you? Why don't you tell me about Balmora? Balmora is the council seat of Great House Lalu and the largest town in Vvardenfell, except for Vivek City. Located on the Odai River and sitting astride the old ruined Vivek Road, Balmora is an important mercantile trade and travel center. Hightown is the administrative center, with the temple and manor houses. The shops, guilds, and trade houses of the commercial district are north of the river. Labor Town's modest corner clubs and homes are south of the river. Alright, well thank you for that. See, tell me about the river, actually. The River Odai flows through the center of Balmora, to the coast near La Ode. Alright. La Oad, maybe? I don't know. Oh, I got so much crap! I'm gonna keep my magic- That's... The slashing damage on that thing is actually really high. I actually think I'm gonna use this spark sword, actually, over my broadsword. It's actually better than it is on all counts. Alright. Get rid of that helm. We wanna keep our shield. Yes, it is substantially better. I'm gonna hold on to exclusive invisibility. That could prove useful at some point in the future. Okay. See, Faggy's Gem Feeder I wanna hold on to. Inkarian Flight Scrolls. How much money does she have? Enough. I'm going to sell all of those. I'm going to sell the Scroll of Dominion, the Book of Dawn and Dusk. Actually get rid of my poor torches too, because they're not seeming to extinguish. Okay, so what do you have, lady? You got a bunch of chitin arrows. You have a Steel Shard Mauler. Wow, that is some damage. That was a nice weapon, but I'm not gonna use it. Anything else? Journeyman's Retort, Mortar and Pestle. If we want to start doing some alchemy, I'm actually kind of tempted to grab those just to kind of just start screwing with alchemy. I don't know. I'm not going to worry about it now. If you guys want me to kind of tinker with alchemy and stuff, just let me know in the comments. Not too worried. All right, so that's a 453. How about 485? Actually, how about 486? Too much. 476. There we go. Thank you. Goodbye. Okay, I think this is a weapon shop owned by a Khajiit that sells fake Daedric weapons. Yeah, Revere. And he brags about it, and they're just weapons that let you cast Bound. Revere knows why you're here. You want to buy Revere's famous Daedric weapons. What? You say these are not Daedric weapons? No, you're right. But Revere is no liar. When you wish it Revere's friend, demon and devil weapons will be as sharp and fine as Daedric weapons and as light as a Netch'air sack. The magic lasts a short time, but long enough to punch through the toughest armor. Revere buys them direct from the Telvanni. You'll not find any cheaper in all of Balmora. So how much are you gonna be charging for these? Only 165, those actually are quite cheap. Oh no, those aren't the... Oh, it just happens to be that the Fiend Katana is particularly expensive. All right, the Fiend Katana and Tanto are particularly expensive because reasons. I got nothing. Shame you don't have like a silver longsword. I would like that. Nordic Iron Helm, 18. Ah, mine is 18 as well. You don't really have anything else I care about, so you can just go ahead and sod off, Revere. Alright, so this is the Fighter's Guild, this is the Mage's Guild. I think this is... I don't remember what this is. Oh, the armor, okay. I want to go into the Mage's Guild, and this is a bookseller, which... Less than... Oh, I think I actually mixed up the Mages and the Fighter's Guild. Damn it! It's like it's been a while. I honestly couldn't tell you guys how long it's been since I've played these games. Probably, if I were to ballpark it, maybe between 5 and 8 years? Long enough. Are you looking for me? You want to join the Mages Guild? Yes. Yes. You look like the sort we could use in the guild. Well, you take the oath and join? Yes. You are now a member of the Mages Guild. Welcome, associate. When you are ready, you can ask for duties to perform, and once you are ready, you can ask me about advancement of the guild. And the reason we want that is because they won't teach us spells otherwise, as you can see here. However, all right, you won't teach us anything. Just because she won't doesn't mean that no one will. Will you let me do enchanting? Yes. All right. I want to enchant, let's see, for example, my silver short sword with Restore Health on... I don't remember how to make it on Strike. I think it may be on Touch for... Let's see here, we'll go with 1 to 10. Okay. So it's on Touch, I don't know. Oh, there we go, it's at the bottom. I'm just being dumb. Cast on Strikes, there you go. So we could enchant this. Sadly, we do not have any Soul Gems. However, there's a bunch of soul gems just sitting right here. I will, but don't take too much time. Sitting here just waiting to be ganked, and once she leaves, I'm going to. Do you have anything I care about for sale? What is that? A dire viper blade. Poison damage on strike. That's actually pretty nice. A healing shield. That is, nah. Holy tower shield. Which is substantially worse than the blessed shield, I don't know why. Amulet of stamina, restore fatigue. Oh, that's nice. Doze charm. What she want for that value? Seriously, like 5? All right, if she's selling it for 5, I will go ahead and just take that. Let's see, what else do we have here? Blighted Kogati. I'm gonna grab a soul gem as well. No, I'm not actually gonna grab a soul gem because realistically, I don't think I wanna blow all of my money identifying it. So now you'll see here that we have an amulet of stamina, and it costs 1 to cast it, and it has 5 charges. So we do this, and you'll see it in the bottom right there, down by our, what is now a fist, and we can cast it just like anything else. So there you go, we use the charge. System works. The only weird thing is it seems it wants us to equip it each time for whatever reason. I do want to come in here before I forget, and since I have traded away my sword, go ahead and equip our Spark Sword. All right, and I know I am here in town to speak with Caius Cassades, but we're gonna do that later. I can go ahead and be sheet that one to find.
I suppose it is my duty spells. To help those less Thank fortunate you. Than myself.
I hate high elves. A feather. This will let us carry 20 extra pounds for 10 seconds, which... The reason that I would want to grab this is because spell creation, you can only create spells based off of spell effects you already know. So this is only 20 for 10 seconds, but knowing this, I could create, say, one that's 100 for an hour if I wanted to, although I don't think spell durations go that high. Okay. Paralysis. Yeah, she doesn't really have anything that interests me. She does allow spell making, which, for example, as you can see here, we can create a better healing spell for ourselves, although Hearth Heal is just magnificently good. But as you can see, you can do a lot, and part of one of the mods that I'm running, the Code Adjuster, it actually lets us do higher values than normal. Normally these would cap at 100, but for example, if I wanted to make me a spell that healed for 500 points a second for 5 minutes, it would only cost me 37,000 mana, which I would obviously never be able to cast, but you know, the option is there. You can get the ability to cast really powerful stuff like that by using alchemy to create potions that'll up your skills and having gear that ups it and stuff. So she will also train us, but I am not willing to pay what she wants us to pay. And yes, I am willing to go a little bit over 20 minutes because funsies.
Yes.
I think this is the teleporter. Yeah, she'll teach us some spells as well. Soul Trap, yes. Some summoning magic, which I'm not too interested in. Spell absorption, flame guard, which is actually kind of useless to us because we have 75% resistance to fire because dark elf. Nothing else I really care about. I would love someone here to teach me restoration magic. What brings you to Ajira's shop? Do you want duties from Ajira? Do you want the local brews or perhaps help in a fight, really? Ajira sells potions of restored health for when you are bleeding, and potions of restored fatigue when you are weary. Really? Oh man, I'm sure these are gonna be expensive. Fortify health. I don't want fortify, I want restore. Because I'll buy some healing potions. Restore agility, endurance, fatigue, health. 35. It's three of them. I will buy all of those. Sure. Here, I'll pay you 100. Excellent. And that is leveling our bartering. Hey there. You have spells that are useful to me. Buoyancy, swift swim, water breathing. That I actually think I'm gonna grab. Open door for popping locks. See, this right here is my tower key, but the difference is that, you know, my tower key is free to cast. Levitate, that's some swift flight, which is kind of nice. Some shielding spells, which I believe shield, the value is just an flat armor bonus it gives you. I'm tempted to grab, honestly, levitate, because that would probably let us get into some places that we probably shouldn't otherwise get into, but we won't worry about that too much now. Hey, are you the healer? Wow, you are a thing. Strong feather, 50 points, but it's only for 10 seconds. It's, you know, I need, you know, 45 minutes. All right, here's a restore health spell that is much weaker than ours. Cure poison. Yes, just in case. Cure common disease on other. Dispel, various resists, calm creature, fifth barrier. Strong feather. I'm tempted to, the spell resist or the... Well, you know, here, spell, were you the one that sold feather? Yes. Give me your crappy feather spell, and let me see if I can make one that isn't crap. On self, let's bump the duration up to 5 minutes here. And we'll bump it up to a magnitude, holy crap. Man, the cost on that is... All right, what about for like a minute? Can I even do that? Yeah, 10% chance, and it costs pretty much all of my spell points. That is rough. Even the base feather, I've only got a 32% chance to cast it. Wow. I can't remember. I could have sworn you could sort these, but I guess not. Man, that is rough. And our chance to cast Soul Trap is actually kind of low as well. Man, I could have sworn there was actually somebody in here that would teach you healing magic. That's what I really want, is give me restore fatigue, you jerks. And you need to go to bed so that I can steal your stuff. Barter, you have nothing. Actually, now that I'm a member of the Mages Guild, I wonder. Save. Oh, 03. We're gonna try stealing from this place. Yes. I don't think it'll let us.
Over here.
Yeah. Oh no. Oh. And this is why you don't steal from mages. They fuck your shit up. But I suppose this is as good a place as any to call it an episode. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. Next time, well, I should say, yeah, next time we're probably going to go ahead and seek out Caius Cassades and begin the main quest. Until then.